I'm deeply honored.
Chancellor Yu, Vice Chancellor Lehman, President Hamilton, Chairman Berkeley, members of the board, faculty, alumni, friends, proud parents, and the graduates of our great school, NYU Shanghai, congratulations to all 270 students in the 2019 class.
谢谢，我今天非常荣幸得到这个奖章。尊敬的余校长 Lehman 校长 Hamilton 校长 Berkeley 理事长各位理事啊、各位老师学友朋友骄傲的家长们和我们牛掰的上纽大2019毕业班的同学恭喜你们今天毕业了恭喜2019同学们 2019 is a very special year for you because you are graduating, but also because it is a year full of important anniversaries in China and the rest of the world. 2019是一个特殊的年份，这是我们这届同学毕业的年份。2019更是中西文化 各自百年交汇的纪念年份. 2019 marked the 500-year anniversary of the European Renaissance. Remember Leonardo da Vinci? Da Vinci spent his last years in Amboise in central France, where the king gave him a chateau and told him, "Here, Leonardo, you will be free to dream, to think, and to work." Leonardo died at Amboise in May 1519, almost 500 years to this day. French President Macron held a ceremony there 2 weeks ago to pay respect to this great Renaissance giant. 2019 also marks the 100-year anniversary of May 4th Youth Movement here in China. 100 years ago, we began to use vernacular writing, 白话文, and we started to embrace contemporary education. 今年呢是2019年, 是欧洲文艺复兴500周年。 大家都记得达芬奇吧？达芬奇最后的岁月是在法国中部卢瓦尔河谷 Amboise 度过的。当时的国王给了达芬奇一个城堡，国王告诉他：“达芬奇，你享有自由，自由的去梦想，自由的去工作。”1519年。 达芬奇就是500年前达芬奇在Amboise去世。法国总理马克龙大约2周之前主持了一个纪念仪式，向这位文艺复兴的巨匠致敬。2019年是我们中国五四运动、五四青年运动100周年。100年前，我们开启了白话文的写作。100年前。 中国开始了现代教育的进程。Then in 1978, about 40 years ago, China's great leader Deng Xiaoping initiated the open door policy. A few years after that door was opened, I went through it and set my foot in America. I started in Oregon, then Ohio, before I finally made it to NYU. When I graduated from the Stern School in 1992, I had an MBA and I had gained some sensibility. But my friends at NYU used to tell me, "Peggy, you are too shy and too nice to survive New York." Yes, I was a bit shy and I was poor. But I was also resilient and very patient. 大概40年前, 伟大的中国领导人邓小平开启了我国的开放。 最终我去到了纽约大学。1992年我从 Stern 毕业的时候，兜里有了个 MBA， 也找到了一些感觉。我在纽约大学的同学经常说，哎呀 Peggy 啊，你人太好，但是呢太面，你在纽约根本生存不下去。的确我当时有点拧巴，口袋里很穷，但是我非常有耐心，我一直坚持。 Decades have passed and not only did I survive New York, I also built up Dangdang, a solid e-commerce company in China, and I raised a family. All of you who are graduating here today have had, like Leonardo da Vinci, the freedom to think and to dream. Now you have a NYU Shanghai diploma under your belt. This is a great asset, and I wish all of you to utilize it to the fullest potential. 几十年过去了，我不仅在纽约生存得很好，我在中国创业，我领导着当当网，我们是一家受人尊重的电商公司，我还抚养了个家庭。今天所有这里毕业班的同学，你们与当年达芬奇一样，你们享有自由，思考的自由，追梦的自由。上纽大的学位是你的资产，是你的财富，我希望你们能把这个财富最大化的使用。 As your fellow alumni, an entrepreneur and a mother with a college kid about your age, I would like to share a few thoughts of mine with all of you at this very special momentUnlike Jeff Lehman, he had, I counted, 8 points of advice, and I only have one. Life is a long distance run. Please take your time and do not rush. There's an English expression that says, youth is wasted on the young. But in my mind, youth is meant to be wastedby the young. So go ahead and waste your youth on meaningful things. Spend time wandering around, reading, observing, accumulating knowledge and capabilities. Allow yourself to be confused and allow yourself to make mistakes. I am prone to almost all mistakes in my life. And mistakeI benefit more from mistakes than my success. Mistakes make me think deeper and act faster. 我是大家的校友、学长、企业家和一个母亲。我的孩子在大学念书，年龄跟你们相仿。在今天这个特殊的时刻呢，我想和你们分享一些我的看法。刚才利门校长，我仔细数了数，好像有8点到9点建议给到大家，我仅仅只有一点。生活是长跑，请慢慢来，不要着急。因为有一句话我并翻译不好，用我自己的话就是说，青春是用来浪费的。走出去，去浪费你们的青春，把青春浪费在有意思的事情上，去兜兜转转，去阅读，去观察，去积累知识，去积累能力，允许你自己彷徨，也允许你自己犯错。人生能犯的错我差不多全都犯过，错误会比成功让我自己更受益，因为错误会让我深入思考，快速行动。 I read a poemOn WeChat a few months ago, it went like this. New York is 3 hours ahead of California, but it does not make California slow. Someone graduated at the age of 22, but waited 5 years before securing a good job. Someone becomes CEO at 25 and died at 50. Obama retires at 55.But Trump starts at 70. Even Trump started his presidency at the age of 70. He is still an impactful president for both good and bad.
我几个月前呢, 在微信上看到一首诗, 它大概这么样讲, 在时间上, 纽约走在加州前面三个小时, 但是加州并没有更慢。 有人22岁就毕业了, 但等了5年才找到好工作。 有人25岁坐上了CEO, 却在50岁去世。 奥巴马55岁退任总统, 但特朗普70岁才打卡。 尽管特朗普70岁才就任总统, 但他依旧是有一个冲击力的总统, 好坏我不评论。
While I say youth is to be wasted, please remember, waste your youth. Do not waste your time. Don't take so many selfies. Use your eyes as camera to take in and process what you see with your brain. Live a life and don't bother to record a life. Your memoirs can wait a few decades to be written up by itself.
尽管我说青春是用来浪费的, 请你一定记住, 浪费你的青春, 但是不要浪费你的时间。 少照点自拍, 把你的眼睛当成相机, 用你的双眼去观察, 用你的大脑去思考你的观察。 去生活, 别忙着记录生活, 你的人生传记可以等好几十年, 慢慢写, 你的人生传记也许会自生成。
Youth is your passport. Issue yourself visas to different destinations all over the world, mentally or physically. Go out to explore, to learn, and to enjoy. Eventually, you will process and benefit what you have gained along the journey. Have a happy life and be at service to your family, friends, and the community.
青春是你的护照, 签证需要你们自己各位签发, 无论是脑海中还是现实里, 请签发你自己, 全网各地的签证, 走出去, 丈量世界, 探索未知, 最终, 你的人生旅途会意义非凡。 我希望大家的人生能是愉悦自己, 服务他人。 谢谢。